To illustrate to our viewers who don't remember just how successful Tommy James and the Shondells were back then, in 1968 and 1969, Tommy James and the Shondells sold more single records than any other artist in the world, including the Beatles.
That's true. Singles, not albums.
That's right. And with all this success, you go on to the Ed Sullivan Show, and what does he do but mispronounce your name?
But he did your homework.
I couldn't believe
it. Boy,
that.
That's true.
I don't know if that was the first time he mispronounced somebody's name. But what did
well,
he
Well, Ed
do?
Would
tell
hit
us
a few.
Story.
You know, Ed was doing the Ed Sullivan Show.
Tell us the story.
Yeah. Talking to Ed was always a challenge.
Yeah.
And I loved him because, you know, by the time, it was like Yankee Stadium,
yeah.
The Ed Sullivan thing.
Yeah, yeah.
So, but the first time we were doing the show, I was scared to death.
I bet.
And it was live television, and they wanted us to do Crimson and Clover live, and you knew that was going to be a disaster. Just the sound of it, just saying it, you knew it was going to be a disaster. So we had just finished the tour of the Beach Boys, and so we were all sitting together at the Riot House, the Hyatt House on Sunset Strip, yeah. After the tour, the week before I was going to do the show,
right.
Where he's introducing next week's acts. And yeah. All right, here. For the youngsters, Tony Jones and the Spondells.
Not even close.
No. So, and it went downhill from there.
Oh.
And so Tony Jones and the Spondells.
Oh. Right?
And I talked to Ed after the show, and he behaved himself. He finally got James right.
Got it.
Engelbert Humperdinck, he can pronounce.
He can pronounce
James.
James was tough for him.
But anyway, God bless him, because he had us on several
and
times.
And it was the show at the time.